Hi guys, welcome on my channel Crochet with Joanna. Today I'm going to show you another beautiful ovoid doily. This doily is quite long. It measure about 30 inches long and is about 13 inches wide, so 30 long and 13 inches wide. For this project I am using crochet hook size 1.75 millimeters and the thread in size number 10, 280 meters equals 50 gram of the thread, so I think one ball for this project will be enough. Basically it all depends how you are working. If you are working quite loosely, you maybe need a little bit more than 50 gram. So if you are new on my channel, don't forget to subscribe, and now we can start. Our work, we are going to start by making slip knot, then chain of 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Slip stitch into the first chain stitch to form a ring, and our first strand we are going to start by making chain of 3 as the first double crochet. Now into the ring we have to make 23 more double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and basically we have to continue until 23, so we should have 24 double crochets in total, and at the end we need to work slip stitch in our third chain of the first double crochet, so exactly at the top. Now we are going to start second round, and again chain of 3 as a first double crochet, and now chain 5 as a chain 5 space. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now we have to skip the next two stitches, 1 double crochet into the third double crochet, chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Skip next two stitches, double crochet into the third one, chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Skip next two stitches, double crochet into the third one and chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. The same pattern now we have to repeat all the way around. So each time we have to work double crochet in third double crochet, then chain of 5. So at the end we should have 8 double crochets and 8 chain 5 spaces. Now we've got the third round, so after slip stitch into the top of chain 3 in our first double crochet, now we have to make slip stitch into the first chain stitch and then into the chain 5 space. Chain of 3 as the first double crochet, then into the same chain space we have to make another 6 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Chain of 3, then in next chain space we have to work 7 double crochets. So in our first chain space we've done 7 double crochets. Chain 3 is a count as the first one and then another 6. And now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, then chain 3 again. In next chain space 6 double crochets, 7 double crochets, sorry. So the same pattern now we have to repeat all the way around. In each chain space we have to make 7 double crochets, then chain 3 space between each group. Round number 4, we have to start after slip stitch in our double crochet first top of chain 3 by making again chain of 3 as a double crochet, then we need to make 1 double crochet in next 6 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So we've got 7 double crochets again. Now chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In our last round we had a chain 3 space, then 7 double crochets. Now we've got 7 double crochets and chain of 5. And again, 1 double crochet in next 7 double crochets. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Then chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And again, 1 double crochet in next 7 double crochets. So the pattern is staying exactly the same. We have to work 1 double crochet in each from our previous round, and between each groups we have to work chain of 5. Round number 5. Again, chain of 3 as a first double crochet, and now in each double crochet we have to work 1 double crochet. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Chain of 3. Then in chain 5 space we have to make 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Chain of 3 again. 1, 2, and 3. Then 1 double crochet in next 7 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Chain of 3, then 3 double crochets in chain 5 space. 1, 2, and 3. Chain of 3. And the same pattern we have to repeat all the way around. So basically 1 double crochet in each double crochet from the previous round, then chain 3, 3 double crochets in chain 5 space, chain 3, and again. Now we've got round number 6. Again, chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 6 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Chain of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And now we've got group of 3 double crochets. In first double crochet we have to work 2 double crochets. 1, and into the same 2. So we've got 2 stitches. 1 double crochet into the second, and 2 double crochets in last one. 1 and 2. Chain of 4. Then 1 double crochet in next 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Chain of 4. Then in first double crochet we have to work 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, 1 double crochet in next double crochet, and 2 double crochets into the third one. So again, now we've got group of 5 double crochets. Then one more time chain of 4, and we have to repeat 1 double crochet and next 7 double crochets, chain 4, then 2 double crochets in first one, 1 in a second, and 2 double crochets in a third one. Now we've got round number 7, and we have to start by making chain of 2 as the first part of the double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next stitch. Now 1 double crochet in next 3 stitches. 1, 2, and 3. Then 2 double crochets together in next 2 stitches. 1 and 2. Chain of 5. Then 1 double crochet in next 5 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And again, in our first 2 double crochets, we have to work 2 double crochets together. So, in through first 2 loops in first stitch, then into the next one, through first 2 loops, and then through all 3. 1 double crochet in next 3 stitches, 1, 2, and 3. Then in the last 2 stitches, 2 double crochets together again, through first 2 loops 1, and through first 2 loops 2. Now through all 3. Chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now 1 double crochet in next 5 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then again, 2 double crochets together in first 2 stitches, 1 double crochet in next 3, and 2 double crochets together in last 2. And the same pattern we have to repeat all the way around. Now we've got round number 8, and we have to start by making chain of 2 instead of the first part of the first double crochet. And now we are going to make 5 double crochets together. So in each stitch we have to make only the first part of the double crochet. Through first 2 loops, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So now we should have 5 loops on the hook and we can finish the stitch. Now chain of 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. In next group of 5 double crochets, we have to make 5 double crochets together again. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 6 loops on the hook, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Then into the next group of 5 double crochets, we have to work exactly the same. So now, all the way around, we have to work 5 double crochets together and then chain of 11 after each group. And now chain of 11 again. Round number 9. We are going to, after slip stitch on the top of our 4 double crochets together, so in this big loop, we have to start by making chain of 3 as the first double crochet, and now 13 double crochets in our chain 11 space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 13. Then we are going to the next group of 5 double crochets together and 1 double crochet on the top again. In next chain space, again another 13 double crochets. So basically we have to repeat the same pattern all the way around. In each chain 11 space we have to make 13 double crochets and the 1 double crochet on the top of each 5 double crochets together. Round number 10, we after slip stitch in top of chain 3, we have to make slip stitch in first double crochet of our group with 13 double crochets. Now chain of 2, this is only the first part of the double crochet, and now into the next 2 stitches, we have to work 2 double crochets together. So for first 2 loops one time, last loop need to stay on the hook, and again, in next stitch, through first 2 loops. Now we've got 3, and we can work through all 3. In next 7 stitches, 1 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And we should have the last 3 double crochets in our group. At the end we need to make 3 double crochets together as well. So through first 2 loops 1, then 2 and 3. Now we've got 4 loops, we can finish the stitch. Now we have to make chain of 5. 3, 4, 5. Then we have to skip double crochet as we've done on the top of 5 double crochets together, and we are going directly to the next group of 13 double crochets. In first 3 stitches, 3 double crochets together, the same as we've done at the beginning of our round. Then in next 7 stitches, 1 double crochet. And the same pattern we have to repeat all the way around. So after 7 double crochet in last 3, we have to work 3 double crochets together, chain 5, and in next group we have to work exactly the same. So each time we have to make 3 double crochets together, then 7 double crochets, another 3 double crochets together, chain 5, and each time we have to skip double crochet as we've done on the top of 5 double crochets together. Now we've got round 11. After slip stitch on the top of our 2 double crochets together, so in that big loop, again we have to start by making chain of 2 as the first part of the double crochet, and then into the next 2 stitches we have to make 2 double crochets together again. 1 and 2. When we've got 3 loops, we have to finish the stitch. Now 1 double crochet in next 3 stitches. 1, 2 and 3, then 3 double crochets together in next 3 stitches. 1, 2 and 3. 4 loops on the hook, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Single crochet in chain 5 space. Chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And we have to repeat. So in our first 3 stitches, we have to make 3 double crochets together again. So 1, 2 and 3. 1 double crochet in next 3 stitches. 1, 2 and 3. Then 3 double crochets together in the last 3 stitches. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Single crochet in chain 5 space. Then chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And the same pattern now we have to repeat all the way around. So we need to make 3 double crochets together in our first 3 stitches, 1 double crochet in next 3 stitches, and in last 3 double crochets again 3 double crochets together. So as we've done here, then chain 7, single crochet in chain 5 space and another chain of 7. Now we've got round 12. So after slip stitch on the top of our 3 double crochets together, we are going to start with chain 2 as the first part of the double crochet. And now we have to make 5 double crochets together. So in each stitch now we have to work only the first part of the double crochet. So through first 2 loops only. 1, 2, 3 and 4. 5 loops on the hook, now we can finish the stitch, and now chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Single crochet in chain 7 space, then again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Single crochet in next chain space, chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And now 5 double crochets together again. So in each stitch, first part of the double crochet and the last loop need to stay on the hook each time. 6 loops, we can finish the stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And the same pattern now, we have to continue all the way around. So 5 double crochets together, and between each group we have to work 3 chain 7 spaces. So after our last chain 7 space, we have to work slip stitch on the top of our chain on the top of our 4 double crochets together, and we can fasten off, then cut the yarn, because the next part of this project we have to start from the beginning, and we need to start by making slip knot, then chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Into the 6th chain from the hook, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, you have to make first double crochet, and then in next 4 chain stitches we need to make 1 double crochet in each as well. So the first row is always the hardest. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we've got 5 double crochets in a row and chain 5 space at the beginning. Now we have to work chain of 2, then we are going to our main part and we have to join in chain 7 space, basically any chain 7 space. After chain 2 slip stitch, then another chain 2, and we have to turn our work. Now 1 double crochet in each double crochet from the previous row. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. After 5th double crochet now, we have to make another chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we have to turn our work again. So make sure that you are not twisting this slip stitch too much. And 1 double crochet in our 5 double crochets from the previous row. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And again, chain of 2, then slip stitch into the next chain 7 space, chain of 2 and 1 double crochet. So again we have to turn our work, 1 double crochet in 5 double crochets from the previous row. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now chain of 5 again. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Then we have to turn our work again and 1 double crochet in our next 5 double crochets. So the pattern is staying exactly the same. So each time when we've got chain 5 space on our left side now, we have to join to the next chain 7 space. Chain 5 spaces on our right side, we have to leave for joining next part. So on this side, so each second row, we have to join to the chain 7 space, and so this is each second row. We start from the second, then 4th, 6th, 8th, 10th, 12th and all the way around. And then I will go back to you to show you what we have to do next. I'm almost at the end, Basically, I've done my last single crochet in last chain 7 space. So the same as we are working all the way around, we have to, after single crochet, make chain 2, then we need to turn our work and we have to work the final row. So after chain of 2, double crochet in our first double crochet, so now I am on my wrong side, and we have to go to the first row. After first double crochet, we need to work slip stitch into the first double crochet, or actually chain stitch, as we've done exactly at the beginning of our round. After slip stitch, we have to make double crochet into the second double crochet, then slip stitch into the second chain stitch from the beginning. Double crochet into the third double crochet, then slip stitch into the third double crochet, double crochet into the fourth double crochet, slip stitch into the fourth, double crochet into the fifth double crochet, then slip stitch into the fifth. And basically that's it. Now we can fasten off and cut the yarn. Our round is done, and as you can see, everything is correct. We have row with chain 5 spaces here, then on the opposite side, here on the opposite side. So the number of rows we've got exactly as we should. And in a minute I will go back to you to show you what we have to do next. So now we are going to make two small flowers before we will join them. And we are going to start in exactly the same way as with the bigger part. Slip knot, then chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Slip stitch into the first chain stitch. Now round 1. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, and then into the ring we have to make another 23 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, and 23. At the end we have to work slip stitch into the top of chain 3, so into the first double crochet. Now we are going to start second round by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain of 4 as a chain 4th space. Then we need to skip our 2 double crochets, 1 double crochet into the third one, chain 4, skip next 2 stitches, double crochet into the third one, chain of 4. Skip next 2 stitches, double crochet into the third, chain 4, skip next 2 stitches, double crochet into the third. And now we need to continue, so at the end we should have 8 chain 4 spaces and 8 double crochets. Now we've got the third round, and after slip stitch into the top of chain 3, we have to work slip stitch in first chain stitch. Now chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 6 more double crochets into the same chain space, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, chain of 3, then another 7 double crochets into the same chain space, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, chain of 3. In next chain 4 space another 7 double crochets. So basically the same pattern now we have to repeat all the way around. In each chain 4 space we need to make 7 double crochets and between each group of 7 double crochets we have to work chain 3 space. Now we've got round number 4 and this is actually the last one round in this part and we have to make chain of 2 as the first part of the double crochet. Now we are going to make 7 double crochets together. So this is our first one and in each stitch now we have to make first part of the double crochet. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We should have 7 loops on our hook. Now we can work through all 7 loops. Add extra chain stitch for lock. So quite tight. And now chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Single crochet in chain 3 space. Then chain of 7 again. 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. In next group of 7 double crochets, we have to make 7 double crochets together again. So only for first 2 loops each time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now we should have 8 loops on our hook. We have to work through all of them. Chain 1 for lock, then chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Single crochet in chain 3 space, then chain of 7 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And in next group of 7 double crochets, we have to work 7 double crochets together again. Then chain 7, single crochet in next chain 3 space, another chain 7. And this pattern we have to repeat all the way around and then make another the same part from the beginning. Okay, so after when we've done our small motifs, basically we need to wait with joining because first of all we have to work the sides. So as you can see, I've done my first side already to show you how it's going to be looks like. And because with the second one we have to join two sides together, I decided to show you this way with the first part done to show you basically now everything, how we need to do the side and how we need to join the second part to the first one already. So at the moment we are going to start with the beginning. And then I will show you what the difference are between the first and the second part. So at the beginning, basically, we have to mark any chain space. Then from this part, we need to count 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. The first and the tenth we have to mark. This is what we need to join the small part. Then another 14, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 we are going to use to join the side. Then again, after 14th we have to count 10. So this is the first one, this is the tenth. And on this side from the next one we've got 14 chain 5 spaces for another side again. So 2 times 10, So make sure that after 10th, when you are counting till 14, the next 10th is on the opposite side, exactly on the opposite side. And here you should have 14 chain 5 spaces as well. So in total we've got 48 chain 5 spaces. Our work, we are going to start by making slip knot. Then chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Now we have to make double crochet in 6 chain from the hook. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And in next 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we should have chain 5 space and 5 double crochets. Exactly the same as we've done here, so on our bigger part. You have to make chain of 5, 3, 4, 5, then 10 our work and make 1 double crochet in next 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Chain of 5. 1, or actually chain of, this is our first, second chain of 5, yes, 3, 4 and 5. Then we need to turn our work and make another 5 double crochets. So 1 double crochet in each double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So now we are going to start the fourth row and we have to start by making chain of 2, then single crochet in a, then slip stitch into the chain 5 space, chain of 2, then we have to turn our work again and another 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Then we have to turn our work again and another 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I missed the first one. One, two, three, four, and 5. And again, chain of 2, then we have to make slip stitch in our previous chain 2 space. Because we've done slip stitch in chain 5, then we had chain of 2. Now chain of 2 again and another 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we have to turn our work and another 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Chain of 2, slip stitch into the previous chain 2 space, chain of 2. So this is the third time as we are joining into the previous. First chain 5, then chain of 2, now chain of 2 as well. Now chain 2 and another 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Chain of 5 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And another 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now we are before the 10th row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And we have to start by making chain of 2. Then double crochet in chain 5 space as we start with first joining. So we had two chain 2 spaces, and at the beginning we had the proper chain 5 space. And we have to make double crochet in that chain 5 space before we got 10th row. And now the next chain of 2 and again another 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now, basically, we have to make chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 5 double crochets without any joining. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then chain of 5 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And again 5 double crochets. And we should continue if we've got the first part in exactly the same way without joining until we will reach row 16. Before row 16 we have to stop. If this is our second part, we have to stop before row 15. So far I've done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I'm going to add another 3 rows because this is my second part. If you this is your first part, just go to row number 16 and you will going to skip the small parts as I show you.